They always turn the mic off on me. Anyway, how many of you are familiar with 3D sound? Okay, probably the people in this area are going to be the only ones hearing it. The rest will hear both speakers. And the,
you want the radio mic?
No, I want this mic. Okay. I just want this up a little bit, okay. Chuck. Woo!
Is that pretty much okay?
Okay, that's good. Right. Mr. Froggy. Okay. First of all, everybody knows that if we just have direct sound, we have a mono signal, right? And that there is no left and there is no right. It's only between your two ears that you can determine if there's depth in the mono. All right, so what I want to do is I want to take a left channel and a right channel. In the left channel, what I want to do with this is I want to make a new channel. So I want to take left minus right on this side, which means it's going to subtract from this side. And I want to take right minus left on this side. Then I want to add right minus left. So now, with this right here, which is simplified, I have just created a new left channel. And I want to do identically the same thing with this side. And I'm going to come up with a new right channel. But is anybody familiar with what that does? If I just do it this way. No, it's impossible to make it a mono. You'll see. Anyway, if I do it just this way, I have a subtraction, don't I? Between the right channel and the left channel. And that means that I only have the spatial field and nothing in the center out here. So, what I want to do with the interferometer is I want to say left and right, and I want to go left plus right and right plus left. All right, following that? So now, do I not have mono that basically is summed together to make one channel? And then I want to split that. Where I have this left plus right and this right plus left. Now, I'll stop right here and I'll give you an example of that. And if you can't hear, get up and get to the center. Now,
just closed.
That's over there.
I was standing at an intersection waiting for the light to change. It was a foggy night in the city.
Now what I want you to notice is the signal. Because I've already did this. I've already made this happen. I've taken the signal and combined left plus right and right plus left and spatially enhanced it when I did this. So what the scope's gonna show you is a straight line in this direction. This little guy right here, that's you. So you got an ideal seat. Was he directly in the center? From what you were hearing? Yeah, because you're a little to the right. But you actually have to be, we couldn't place it ideally for everybody. But when we go into spatial sound, and everybody's going to hear identically the same thing. All right? So let's go back and let it continue and listen to his voice for a minute.
Streets were empty and it was late.
Watch the scope.
She appeared out of nowhere, started talking to me. So we were already in the middle of a conversation. I don't think I'd ever seen her before. The more I listened to her, the more I realized there was something about her I recognized.
See, it's not a direct straight line.
When you step in a rake, you notice the handle slaps you right between the eyes.
That there's space in the mono.
I'd known her before, all right. Only in another place a long, long time ago. Suddenly she was this.
All right, now the next thing to do is now that we have the mono, we want to take this portion of it and we want to X this. We want to make a circuit that can switch back and forth and do it without your ears doing it, without your ears hearing it actually. Okay, so if we go back to the beginning of this recording and we listen to what people call stereo, this is what it sounds like. If you can't see, get up and come and look.
The bars had just closed.
That's pretty narrow, isn't it?
I was standing at an intersection waiting for the light.
So let's enhance the stereo a little bit.
It was a foggy night in the city. The streets were empty and late. She appeared out of nowhere. Started talking to me as though we were already in the middle of a conversation. I don't think I'd ever seen her before.
Can you hear back there?
The more I listened to her, the more I realized there was something about her I recognized.
Get up and look if you...
Then it hit me. Like when you step on a rake and the handle thwaps you right between the eyes. I'd known her before, all right. Only in another place a long, long time ago.
So we'll just keep... Yeah. We'll just keep going back and forth till you fully see what the effect is going to be. I don't want to surprise you. There's some things that it can do that are sort of shocking to some people. But these processors were never marketed. Basically, only the base system, which was for the movies and for the CDs. Anyway, You have these ranges here, see, 1, 2, 3, 4. In each one of these ranges, I put a little colored tab so that they're increments of what space is. All right, so now let's go back and I'll just enhance it a little bit.
Bars have just closed. I was standing at an intersection waiting for the light to change. It was a foggy night in the city. The streets were empty and lights. She appeared out of nowhere and started talking to me as though we were already in the middle of a conversation. I don't think I'd ever seen her before. The more I listened to her, the more I realized there was something about her I recognized. Then it hit me. When you step on a rake, the handle thwaps you right between the eyes.
Actually, there's more spatial dimension, which your ears are now, how would we say this? They're becoming not blocked. All right, so let's bring it up a little bit more and listen to more. Let's give the amplifier a little gain.
Bars have just closed. I was standing at an intersection waiting for the light to change. It was a foggy night in the city. The streets were empty and quiet. She appeared out of nowhere, started talking to me as though we were already in the middle of a conversation. I don't think I'd ever seen her before. The more I listened to her, the more I realized there was something about her I recognized.
Now while it's running, I'm gonna take it back to stereo, all right?
I'd known her before, all right. Only in another place a long, long time ago.
What happened to you?
Suddenly she was as
all right.
Familiar
so now,
old couch.
Take it up one more level.
Perhaps she looked like a chaise lounge to me. She was the kind of woman who could lie naked on the beach in Tahiti. All you'd be looking at is the shape of her fawn eyes when she dropped her lids on her. She didn't take my breath away, she put it back. I realized I hadn't been breathing right for a long time. My only thought was she's so beautiful it scares me.
Everything's getting different.
The funny thing is, while I listened to her, I started to remember.
We'll return in a minute. What is it that you do not notice? You don't notice the room. There's no echoing of this because this is canceling out the phases that would normally disrupt this in this room. I'm the guy that's in trouble in the room. The music is not. Okay, so if we have to do this one at a time so everybody can hear a guitar that goes through the wall, then we will do it as long as you all get the idea of what interferometry of sound is. So what you do is you must take apart the sound, then you must create a new mono channel, you must create a new spatial channel, you must combine those and then spatially enhance that. Now, when you go to binaural, how many of you have listened to binaural? How do you listen to binaural? Bull. So, let's go to binaural. Let's go back and listen to the program.
Bars have just closed. I was standing at an intersection waiting for the light to change. It was a foggy night in the city. The streets were empty and quiet. She appeared out of nowhere, started talking to me as though we were already in the middle of a conversation.
Notice what's happening here.
I don't think I'd ever seen her before. The more I listened to her, the more I realized there was something about her I recognized.
If you look at the scope, the gain has not changed.
Then it hit me.
What has changed is your ears.
It whaps you right between the eyes. I'd known her before, all right.
So, what is stereo? Here's stereo.
A long time ago. Suddenly she was as familiar as an old couch. But she...
But that's what audiophiles listen to, right? They don't... They
don't... You're the kind of woman who could lie naked on the beach in Tahiti. All you'd be looking at is the shape of her fawn eyes when...
Audiophile is looking for a right and left channel in a focus center. Well, right now you're in a focus center because, see, you're in the mono range here. So what is that telling you that's missing when they make a stereo recording? They're not combining back the mono center. The mono center, everything gives the illusion of three speakers. One, two, three. But this is a phantom, right? There's nothing there. But there is something there. We'll go back and get his voice again. And then I'll move it up. And then we'll have some fun. Let's see here. Right there. This is enhanced mono. That's this portion. This means it's focused to center and it has a little space around the mono.
The bars had just closed. I was standing at an intersection waiting for the light to change. It was a foggy night in the city. The streets were empty and quiet. She appeared out of nowhere, started talking to me as though we were already in the middle of a conversation.
So do we got that? When a spatial signal is running in a room this side, everybody can hear both speakers. You're not stereo. If it was stereo playing without the processor, the people on this side of the room were only hearing this speaker, and the people on this side of the room were only hearing that speaker. But as you spatially enhance by taking the signal apart through interferometry, you do it this way. You're able to flip around those signals, turning one ear on and one ear off. So if we go back to the spatial at the maximum range, everybody should hear both speakers. If you don't, you're deaf in one ear. Now, he should move to the stage.
It's a foggy night in the city.
Which means he's going to back up. Right? So let's back him up a little bit.
She appeared out of nowhere. Started talking to me as though we were already in the middle of a conversation. I don't think I'd ever seen her before. The more I listened to her, the more I realized there was something about her I recognized. Then it hit me. When you step on a rake, the handle thwaps you right between the eyes. I'd known it before, all right. Only in another place a long, long time ago. Suddenly she was as familiar as an old couch.
But she looked like a chaise lounge to me.
was the kind of woman who could lie naked on the beach in Tahiti. All you'd be looking at is the shape of her fawn eyes when she dropped her lids on.
Now,
she didn't take my breath away, she put it
let's
back.
Let's slowly increase a little bit.
I realized I hadn't been breathing right for a long time. My only thought was she's so beautiful it scares me. The funny thing is, while I listened to her, I started to remember. Little pictures would drift into my mind. There was a time long, long ago on our own planet when we went floating in the wind pool. Just the two of us, looking up at the red moons through the rain. And the time we stood in the white cloud tower, our robes glowing in the storm, we promised to love each other forever and ever. I felt her hand on my arm, she said, "Where did you go?" Suddenly I remembered that horrendous battle at Andaris when they carried me away in my shield and she was crying. We took off as fast as we could after that. We had to get away from those electric guns. We kept on going and we traveled to San Bartan on the desert planet and hid out. We took all of her stuff. For several years we traded stolen water for gold. It was a kind of a life that had an edge to it, but I got tired of killing informers. Then I got in some real trouble on Seca 5. I strangled the king. They locked me up for the night. And I lost my head in the village square in the morning. We kind of lost touch after that. Although...
Okay, let's do something to somebody, all right? This is the ideal spot on a binaural system is to be focused between the two speakers, right and left. So what I want to do is get somebody directly center, and I'm going to ask him where things are. Do you want to do it? Do you want to do it? Or do you want to do it? Okay, move the chair. You're going to have to... You're going to have to get right. Actually, I want you about this far away. Right?
To the left.
Yeah, just move to the left a little. Well, one of these days. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to use the door. So you do realize this analog recording that somebody digitized, right? Okay, let's do it with the glasses, John. Yes. Yes. Okay, so we're going to take this level. Okay, quiet for this guy now. Targo.
I was listening to the organ.
Okay.
Organ was over here.
The guitar was over there, right? Because see him behind you? This guy? He says the guitar's over there. And you're listening to the organ.
Yeah.
Where's the organ?
Here.
Right.
Singer was here.
In the stage?
Yeah.
Right. Okay. Okay, so do we want to continue here? Or do we want to listen to something else that's more spatial? Let's try something else on you. More spatial. Actually, the speakers are the cheapest speakers you could get.
How many do you have? Two?
Just two. No. All right. Let's put a guitar in space, and I won't interrupt the recording, okay? I won't just come back here and interrupt it. I'll just let you listen to the recording. If I ever figure out how it works. Thank you. The thing about the spatial processor is that if you're in spatial, you don't have to be focused anywhere. You just automatically hear it in the room. However, how does it work, right? How does this work? Well, it works really simple. Can you all see this? Smart ass. So, the processor fires a signal to your right ear, and also at the same time generates a signal to cancel the left ear. See how that works? And it does the same on this side. So you're going to say, yeah, but there's all these mono recordings, and I hate to really bore you with this, but is anybody familiar with the ink spots? You know what they sound like? Okay. All right, you're over there, right? You know that it was a mono recording. The originals were mono recordings. There were no stereo recordings. Later on in years, they did make a stereo recording, but to me it just wasn't the same. So here's a 78 record. And I will change the enhancement as we need it. Now, I'm not going to say that I can cure the distortions off the 78 record, but you are going to hear what was really on the 78 record. Grab the disc. Little enhancement.
If I didn't care, more than words can say, if I didn't care, would I feel?
Do you hear the 78 record in the background? Over there, right? Where was the other guy standing in the room?
If I would my begin.
So let's open them up a little bit. Wanna open them up?
For this demonstration, but I will do. I will explain
it. Would I feel this way, darling? If that says love.
Now, if anybody remembers what they were doing on stage, this guy was standing over here. And that was standing on that side, and there were two others right here.
While my heart just stands still so much.
If I didn't care.
So, let's go back to enhanced mono and see what happens to him.
Would my...
Yeah, so let's go up a little bit at a time so you can see what's happening.
Would all this be?
See what happened to you? Okay, let's do better. Let's do better. Processors are funny things. Here's exactly what you want to accomplish if you're going to do a processor. First of all, this is a guy, and that's where you are. You're right here on the scope. The dot, no signal. This is all phases, isn't it? So you can more or less understand that we choose the direction by phase. So if I get somebody and I look directly at them, what is that? If I'm looking directly at you, if I'm looking directly at this guy, what is it? Delta I. That's the intensity at which my voice is striking you. But that doesn't tell you anything because both ears are hearing identically the same thing. But if I look directly at you and I move around the room, what is this? Do both your ears hear the same? Why is that?
Because the sound is coming from different directions. They're flying in different directions.
First of all, with your ears, you know what your eyes do? How do you see? No. What's the image coming to you? It's upside down, isn't it? And then what do the eyes do? They cross it. And that gives you the dimension. So your ears work the same way. And that's delta T. So what does the processor have to do? First of all, it has to be able to control delta I, the intensity in the center. Then it has to be able to control delta T. Then it has to be able to mix the two together to form a new left and a new right. And that's all phase. So, I don't know what level this is at, but. Hate to bore you, but I'm gonna take you back even more. These were taken, so everybody can see this, these Westerns were taken a long time ago. Did anybody ever hear the Haunted Gold Mine? Of course, it's Hopalong Cassidy. But we're just gonna change the processing to what we call a monoblock processor. And the monoblock processor can control delta I, and this will control delta T. So if there's anything that's in the recording that's generated by a computer it may not sound right because a computer can't generate what analog does. It can only simulate. So let's see how we can make this one sound. Okay. Delta I, watch the scope.
Hi, partners, this is your friend Hopalong Cassidy. You'll gather around and be real quiet. I'll tell you a story. The story of the haunted gold mine. It all started when my friend Lucky and I were riding up in the Superstation Mountains. We were going to stop by and say hello to Lucky's father. Well, Lucky, I guess you'll
it's pretty much mono, right?
Sure will, Hopalong.
Is it? Let's go back and start the story again.
But if we hurry, we might make it to Pop's cabin before we get wet. It's only about...
Hi, partners. This is your friend Hopalong Cassidy. You'll gather around and be real quiet. I'll tell you a story. The story of the haunted gold mine. It all started when my friend Lucky and I were riding up in the Superstation Mountains. We were going to stop by and say hello to Lucky's father. Well, Lucky, I guess you'll be glad to see your dad.
Sure will, Huck.
Lucky, it looks like we're going to get caught out in the storm.
You hear both speakers.
It's dark, too, Huck. But if we hurry, we might
but in
the
mono.
Cabin before we get wet. It's only about a mile up this canyon.
Let's go, Topper.
You only hear this speaker and this speaker. Delta I is the intensity at which the mono is coming to you here.
We'll
add more.
Yeah.
Add more space. Delta T.
And it's still lost.
Hurry, Hoppy, it's starting to rain.
This off cabin up ahead.
Boy, it's sure gonna be good to get in out of this storm, Hoppy. Sis! I didn't know you were here.
Lucky and Happy. Come in and get dry.
Thanks, miss.
So we know we can do this, right?
What's the matter, sis?
We can build something.
Oh, Lucky, something's wrong.
That will take and formulate a delta I, which is the intensity, is when I face you. I'm direct to you. The only thing missing then is the time delay between this ear and this ear. So that's delta T. So if we change the milliseconds across here really quick, you get the illusion that it's stereo. The scope thinks it's stereo, and it's not. It's all made up in your head. Okay. So let's get out of it. I just wanted you to know that that's the way the ink spots were done. All right? So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to take this processor, go back to this processor, and is everybody familiar with Crystal Gayle? She's a country singer. One of the great ladies. Let's see actually what Crystal Gayle, since she was dead in it, since she was done in a dead sound booth where there was no space. I think she is five. We're going to enhance her a little bit and see what she really sounds like.
Don't know what's
She sounds good, doesn't she? Watch. It's a dead recording. No space. Nothing. No room. Now listen. What she sounds like right there. So, a while back, a long time ago, Tom Bearden said something about an interferometer. And I said, gee, that's nice. But I was always interested in sound, so I wanted to see what interferometers did to sound. So now here's a, we'll go into a little bit about, this is a little bit more complicated than what I've drawn on the board, okay, because there's two spatial processors, one in the very front when the signal's coming in, and one in the very end that's used in the mixer. And in between those is a circuit that causes this to happen. We term the circuit X. Why? Because it can take the signal and take this signal and move it from this speaker to this speaker and this speaker to this speaker. But it does it without you hearing any. And that's the only way you can do that is in between the processor so that you can throw things out of the speaker or make the sound. Actually, the speakers sound like they're this big because the room isn't interfering. We're being interfered with in the room. My voice is bouncing there, there, back there, right? And there's these room problems. But a spatial processor doesn't have room problems. Now there's a couple others that are problematic. One of them's Roy Rogers. Well, Dale Evans is in this. It depends. Can the recording engineer hear? Absolutely not. They never hear anything. They always say there's not enough treble, there's not enough bass, there's this, there's that. You know what? Why don't you leave it natural and process it correctly? But you'll hear that here. So we'll start out low here. And I'll bring the crowd out.
Trails to you until we meet again. Happy trails.
stereo, right? Do you believe? Bring them out, knock them up.
It's the way you ride the trail that counts. Here's a happy one for you. Happy trail to you. Until we meet again. Happy trail to you. Keep smiling on.
Mistake in the recording. Right there. A lot of people in there, isn't there? You want to know why? Because he had a full stage behind him. It is quite an orchestra. So, but you're listening to it right now in the very first portion of binaural. If I make this binaural, since the recording, you would have to be in the center because Roy Rogers and Dale Evans are going to go to the back where they were. And I'll show that to you. We'll turn the level down. So now you're in binaural. And Roy Rogers and Dale Evans have to move to the back. Guys that are in the center hear that correctly.
It's the way you ride the trail that counts. Here's a happy one for you.
Happy trails to you. Until we meet again.
Happy trails to you. Keep smiling.
Two Dales. There's a double Dale. I just heard her. But I don't hear the double Dale with stereo.
Why is there a double Dale?
Because the room acoustics cancel her out in stereo. There is two. Listen. The wrong one.
Happy trails to you. Till we meet again.
X. X circuit. You can see it here. this way, then that way. Canceling out your ears on one side, and then canceling out on the other side. Gives you the illusion that you have this big space. Take this space
until
away.
We meet again. Happy trails to you.
Stereo.
Mono. Who cares about the clouds and where to gather? Just sing a song and bring the sunny weather. Happy trails to you.
Spatial. Really there. When I walk in front, you're right. When I walk, when I block off that speaker, this is exactly what's happening.
So you never
take your finger. Everybody hold up their finger. Plug one ear. Where's the pressure? It's there. So when I walk in front of the speaker, it's changing that pressure because it can't fire the signal. And that's what you're hearing. Good observation. So what should we try? We've already said happy trails. Let's try something that was a little... And yeah.
You never made these commercially available.
I only made the bass unit, which was used in all the studios. We helped develop a Philips chip. The chip was available, and that was, we did a lot of work with the TDA3810, which is a spatial processor mono chip. Yeah, TDA3810, which are about $65 a chip now on the internet, right? So you don't want to get one because it's very low voltage, and if you burn it out, you won't get another one. This processor down here that's doing that is running two of those on both sides. One before, one after. Let's see, what was I gonna do? Everybody likes this. We'll just leave it in binaural and we'll just see what happens with this. This is a synthesizer generating this. And so what we're gonna tell the processor to do is go into binaural, and you can sort of watch what it's gonna do here. You can see the processor switch this. Center. Which means the ball's over here somewhere. Let's try something like a manhole cover. See what we can get out of that. the processor up. Give it a little gain. Right, it's spinning this way. And you can hear that. It's not spinning this way, it's spinning this way. See where it's going? A little bitty speaker. Yeah, that's not in reality. If you cancel out the room, it's big. But you can see what's happening here as the X circuit switches. Synthesizer doing that in here, and then the X circuit just corresponds to the phases, and it generates its own delta I and delta T, which changes from right to left, decides what signal to cancel out so that you get the illusion that the manhole cover is spinning this way, because that's the way it's spinning. It's a synthesizer doing it, but it's still, it did it. Let's try something else. Boy, I've occupied you pretty good, haven't I? Absolutely. You know what you'd hear? You have 5.1s, you should hear it. Oh, he's back there. Yeah, he is. Because you just heard him go. This, there's no frequency. This is flat. There is no network in this processor that changes frequencies and takes a frequency and says, I'm frequency selective, I'm going to put it over there. That's phony. You wouldn't want to do that. You'd want to keep the exact placement of the instruments on the stage, would you not? You don't want to change anything. You just want to keep it. Now this is interesting. Okay, here, let's do this. Let's play around a little bit with this. We'll leave it in binaural. Let's see here. Yeah. Good, bad, and the ugly. Notice the phase in the recording is this direction. That tells you something right away. That tells you something, that a microphone was out of phase somewhere. Okay, so tells me that there's a signal somewhere in the process that something's inverted in there, because it won't come to center. It won't come this direction. Let's see. Interesting album. So if we go to 9 and see if the same thing occurs with 9. I can straighten it out. Yeah. Hear it? Interesting, isn't it? If you go back. Hear him cancel out? Something's out of phase. That's more correct. Spatial.
But the point of the gun was the only law.
Now it's axing.
When the final showdown came last, my lover was no good.
that fateful love.
See? That night, holds in center.
When Lover G said her people man going out too far. From the moment a girl gets the beetle grow.
Try a little bit more.
Yeah. When two men go out to face each other, only one returns. And then they couldn't help who shot through the mouth. The sun's in heaven.
So, and that's only a small amplifier. Imagine a big one. Okay, let's, but you can see that you can correct this. If you have the correct processor, you can correct it. So I could re-record it, right? Play it on an FM station somewhere, and nobody would ever know. Only I would know. So that's one thing that it can detect and you can correct, because you can change it. So let's just go to a different. Since all the bass recordings were done with country and westerns, I sort of had to listen to every one of them.
See how each was recorded?
Well, I did. Yeah. I didn't.
Can you translate that to an application for live performance and enhance it and to where the center of the
Yeah. You could. Got Katie Daisy Lewis. Live recordings are not a problem. We could do that if I, let me see.
I mean performances. I got recordings.
A PA system that's modeled?
Yeah.
Yeah, you could. You can do whatever you want to do. You can do it with a mono block. Because normally I'm on one microphone here, right? This is mono. Okay, let's do three and see how they did that. Of course, everybody knows this because everybody heard it on TV. Should be got one thing out of phase in the recording. Because if I run off to that side, I just moved everything in space. I didn't pan it, I moved it in space. And I'll move it in space the other direction. You can't do that with a regular preamp. You either go right or you go left. We're controlling it with a spatial processor, so we can do anything we want with this signal. We can move the guy in space. I'll do that in a minute. I moved him over there. You didn't lose this one. Basically, what I'm showing you is I have total control of movement in space, and I'm going to do that with Crystal Gayle. And I will not lose the space. And then I'm going to let you go eat. I think I did over my hour, right? Yeah. It's not my job, man. Come on, let's have fun. It's Friday. It's for free Friday. Okay, let's just assume that a microphone was dead. They didn't know it. And the engineer that recorded it couldn't correct it. You could, if you had control of space, right? You could take the object and place it in space and then add the spatial aspect of it all around. So I'm going to do that with Crystal Gayle. I'm going to look at her mono first. Oh boy. I'm going to listen to her in mono. Then I'm going to move her where I want her. So she's directly center right now.
Don't know when.
Now I'm going to move her over there.
Been so blue. Don't know what come over you. You found someone.
She's over there, right?
And don't it make my brown eyes blue? I'll be fine when you go.
It's over there. No space lost.
All night long. Say it is okay. And don't it make my brown eyes blue?
I just walked her across, right?
Give me no reasons, give me alibis. Tell me you love me and don't let me cry. Say nothing, but don't say goodbye. I didn't mean to treat you bad.
Did it go that direction?
Just what I had.
I'm walking it across in space. You can't walk it across in mono. over here. On this side. Crystal Gayle. You don't lose the space. Now, how many preamps and amplifiers and spatial things Dolby 5.1 can do that? They can't do it. It's to take the object in Delta I and place it in space and then add the space around it. As if she just walked to that side of the stage, right? And so you can see you can do that with it. So you can play all kinds of little tricks with this. Problem is, the industry will not let you put it out there. Why is that? Why do you guys think that is? No, because you don't need a decoder. Oops, John made a mistake. So let's just play. Yep, that is left in the player somewhere.
What is that meaning, that you can't copy it? Is that what? They don't have a decoder, you can't copy it.
You can copy this all you want and not lose the effect of it. The thing about it is that the industry requires that if you're gonna give somebody that can do something to walk things in space and stuff like that, that you must have a decoder. You can't just put it on a CD and I'm gonna give it to you, right? And be able to make a million copies of this. Right, because the spatial processor doesn't care how many times you copy it. The original noise stays.
Is that the 70 or the 108?
This amp,
yeah,
is the 100. 100 per channel. It's a small one. It's a little guy. It's actually about 140 per channel, but...
tried to get this to us commercially.
Oh, absolutely.
No way.
No, man. That, I want this little girl here. I'm going to play around with her. Got to find her. I'm just going to play around with her a little bit. Now you watch this here. I'm just gonna move her in space. Then I'm gonna walk her back. So I got her right there, right? Now, as I move to stereo, you lose that. Right? Now, as I increase the space around her, she stays there, but space changes. So now I move her to center. Directly center when she sings. No phase problem at all. Of course, space is going to be around it. So audio engineers, right? They look at everything. They look at everything. They look at what is this phase, what does this IC sound like, what does this do, what this doesn't do. The ideal situation is you would like to have the exact placement of the instruments on the stage when you're listening. It's almost like wearing a pair of headphones. Because if we wait a couple of minutes and I just go to stereo, you won't want to listen to it. You walk out of the room. Actually, we're all walking out of the room because I'm tired now. So, but anyway, I mean, you're going to have a lot of questions and you can get to me out there, whatever. And the thing is that I just wanted to show you that basically all this technology all ties in together. If you can do this with sound, walk things in space and do things like that, and you can do it, then you can do it with electricity. And you can do it with mechanical things. You can do whatever you want to do if you would just stop listening to them. Because see, they have all the answers. That's why that's not out there. It's, huh? No. This is patented. There's a patent on the internet that shows you exactly what this is. It's under the binaural processor. It's under my name.
But we can't get it.
Yes, you can.
We can.
Google patents.
Type
in John Bedini. And go to Google Patents, and every one of my patents will come up, and you will find that analog vector spatial processor. Well, of course they acknowledge the science. Is can the guy make it and put it out there without interference? Science is not the problem. It's mankind. Mankind's the problem with all this. They're the ones that stop you from having things. There's no problem with the science at all when it comes to doing this. It can be explained. You can look at it. There's no secrets.
But you can't build it.
Oh, you can build it.
You can sell it.
You can sell it.
Yeah.
Onesies and twosies.
Yeah.
But don't ask, you know, for a store to take it on, or a recording studio. They did take on bass. That was very successful for a while. And a lot of recordings were done, and a lot of movies were done in that. Star Trek, The Day the Earth Stood Still, Hunt for Red October, they were all done in bass. The only way for the ship captain to turn around and look directly at you was to move him in space. And it has to be an engineer that's pretty good with controls. For you not to know that space is changing just right there at that point. When I was moving her, I was going very slowly with the movement. So just, yeah, so she was walking across the stage to the people on this side. And when I went the other direction, she was walking across the stage to the people on the other side. But you can't do that without a spatial processor, without an interferometry. And so a hologram, right, and the laser is going to work the same way. Now the next question that everybody asks is, well, gee, if you can do that with audio, what about my TV set? Yes, except for one thing. You have a red, you have a green, and you have a blue. And if you goof up the phases, what do you have? You have black and white. You have 3D black and white. Yeah, you have 3D black and white. And who's going to watch something that's in color and 3D black and white? Might not be bad. Might be kind of interesting. But anyway, that sort of concludes my little demonstration on the sound. And I'll leave it set up so that later on we can play around with it, you know, one-on-one or whatever you want to do. Just don't take my disc. I don't know what this is, and I really don't want to keep you, but I'm going to find out what it is. No, I think it's something that I was interested in because of the cars or something, and the girl, when I first seen these two, it was like incredible to watch. And I'm just gonna see what it is.
Is this pornography?
Yeah, audio pornography.
I bought another car, you bet, don't you wanna go? I bought another car, you bet, don't you wanna go? Take you to some place I've never been before.
I don't know what it is.
I'm going, I'm going.
It's all right.
It's like mine.
It's in phase, right?
I'm going where the water tastes like mine. They jump in the water, stay drunk all the time. I'm in the city, not to
it's good. Two people. So you're getting the X. Who is it, Chuck? Well, now it's got me curious. I think you wrote on it, Chuck.
But not enough.
Kitty, Daisy, and Lewis. Going up the country. So anyway, that's just an example of what you can do with it. And we'll play around with it later. I won't take it down unless somebody needs it, and then I'll just move it to the side. So, go have fun.